So, waiters and waitresses, on my first bell, you can take off the lids. Okay, let's go! So we've got some lovely delights down here at the moment. Mrs. Ellis is going for the snails first. She's going for the snail. She's got a snail. There you go. Here we go. Here we go. Hang on a second. Hang on a second. Sick bucket. Sick bucket. Sick bucket. Max, hold the sick bucket. Let's see, Mr. Gillings. He's gone through a frog's leg. Oh, Miss Patch. She's like an animal. She's like an animal. She's devouring them. We've only got about 10, 15 seconds left. Well done, folks. Let's see how we're going. It's looking pretty good. So, Hoss! Give him a massive round of applause. So, waiters and waitresses, can you clear the tables and get ready for the next meal, please? Mrs. Massey. It's great. Mr. DeSalvo, have you been along and looked at everything? So, you're okay? So, are you okay with your scores? Let's have a look at those. Okay, so I'm going to read out Mr. DeSalvo's scores after the first round as our waiters and waitresses clear the tables. So, currently in fourth place with a score of 6 points, although she made a valiant attempt, it's Mrs. Ellison Vikinghouse. Believe me, you will be so glad that you went first. We have in joint second place Phoenix and Braveheart with 7 points. So, Mrs. Petch, what were those frog's legs like?
They taste like chicken.
So, that's lovely, they taste like chicken, fantastic. Okay, so, competitors, Mr. El Canuni and Mr. DeSalvo are going to come forwards. They're going to give us a clue to our next country. Oh, here we go. So, competitors, who is going next? Who is going next? There's a breakup. We have Mrs. Reynolds. Let's keep the meals back for Griffin. Who's going next? Quickly. Come on. Quickly. Quickly. It's Mr. Towers for Griffin. For Phoenix, it is Miss Copeland. And for Viking, we have, Mr. Swallow. Okay. Can I say, if you just look at the expression on Miss Marshall's face, I've never seen anybody so terrified. You two, as more experienced staff, you are really stitching her up here, let me tell you that. So what I can tell you is, from Australia, if I can get our waiter and waitress to bring the plates out, but don't uncover them. So guys, if you can bring them forward. You've got a selection of 3 different dried foods. You've got some mealworms. You have a selection of mealworms. You have got some mapani grubs. And you all have only one each, a grasshopper. Okay, so if we wait for a second. Okay, so waiters, waitresses, get your ready to serve. This time we are giving our competitors 45 seconds. Oh, and we've got the big screen up, so we can hopefully get some more shots of what's happening. So, 45 seconds. Remember, cheer on your head of house. Just in case you didn't know, we're streaming live on YouTube, so let's give them all a wave. Fantastic. So here we go, 45 seconds. 3, 2, 1, let's go! Oh, Mrs. Reynolds! Oh, down in one. We've got, he's got worms coming out of his mouth. Oh my God, there's lightning, there's thunder, everything's going on. Mr. Swallow's giving it all he's got over there. We've got 15 seconds left. Has anybody cleared? Oh, Miss Copeland's cleared the plate. She's gone for it. She's cleared the plate. We've got Raquel! Let's stop there. Oh, can I just say, is Miss Copeland's daughter in the audience? Is Miss Copeland's daughter anywhere in the audience? She's back there. Your mum, is she such a messy eater at home as well? Look at this. She's got worms all over the place on the here. Mr. Towers cleaning up after himself. How very well mannered he is there. Okay, so Mr. DeSalvo's getting ready. Waiters, waitresses, can you clear the tables? Can I just say, in case you hadn't worked it out, they get worse every time. Just do that again.
No.
Okay, so Mr. DeSalvo, let's have a look at where we're going. Oh, okay, so good enthusiasm, good table manners as well. So that time we had, I'll give you the individual scores, remember totals. So joint third place in that round, we had Viking and Braveheart. In second place, that round it was with 8 points. Second place with 9 points, we had Griffin. And first place with 10 points, Phoenix House. So the scores so far, Viking, you are on 14 points. Phoenix, you are on 17 points. Griffin, you are on 18 points. And Braveheart, you are on 15 points. Are you still eating those things? They're chewy. Are they, what are they like? Are they like chicken? Not so much. Not so much. Right, okay, so let's find out where we are going next. Oh, Mr. DeSalvo, can I give you a scoreboard back, please, sir? Thank you for making an effort to dress up for today. That's fantastic. Oh, that's me on cover. Okay, so let's find out where we're going next. Mr. Alcanuni, Mr. DeSalvo, can you walk along the front and maybe give our audience a clue, please? It's not Laurel and Hardy. Oh. Well, let's get patriotic. We're going to the land of hope and glory. What could it be? What could we have saved from England? So, Braveheart, Mr. Cowley! For Griffin, it's Miss Goodliffe! Phoenix, it's either Wingad or Thriss. Who's going? It's Miss Wingard. And for Viking House, it's Miss Marshall. Okay, so I'll be honest with you. It's not served very often. But this is tripe. Tripe, for those of you that may not be familiar, is the lining of a sheep's stomach. Can I just say, let's give these guys down here a whiff of this. Ashley, come and take a whiff. Come and take a whiff. Oh, Loris, that's minging. Absolutely minging, that is. So let's keep it. Let's keep the lid on. Let's keep the lid on. So, but don't worry. You may need to use your knife and fork with this one, okay? So we're going to give you... It's a bit chewy. So we're going to give you 45 seconds. Okay. Oh, it has been cooked for 3 hours. We're okay. Okay, so you can use your knife and fork, please. Mr. DeSalvo is going to come across. Let's them count them down from 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's go! Oh! Oh, my God. Oh, it's looking good. Miss Marshall, let's come along. We've got Miss Wingard's enjoying. Give them some encouragement. Come on. Cheer them on, Miss Wingard's eating away. Mr. Cowley's enjoying this. It's much better than his wife's cooking at home. Look at him. Oh, he's got a fancy. Loving it. Loving it. Oh, loving it. We've got Miss Goodliffe, who's got a sick bucket next to her. Well done, Louis. Keep the bucket there. We've got 15 seconds left. 15. Go on, Fliss. Oh, no. Oh. Oh, no. Oh, oh, keep it going. Oh, my watch has stopped. We've still got 15 seconds. The watch has stopped. We've still got 15 seconds to go. Let's see, Miss Marshall, tuck in. Tuck in, come on. Tuck in, you've eaten food in Wales. Oh, she's gone for the finger food. Okay, let's stop there. It's so... Oh, I love my job. So, Miss Goodliffe. Fliss. So, just describe that.
Oh, that is vile. That is the worst thing I've ever put in my mouth. That is disgusting.
Okay. You can make up your own jokes. I'm not going there. Right, okay. So, that was good. We've only got one diner left. We only have one diner left. So, waiters, waitresses, can you clear the tables? While we're waiting, we're going to throw a few more sweeties into the audience. Okay, so who wants a few sweeties? Here we go. Oh. So, before we go to our final round, we'll go through the scores so far. So our final competitors know the scores they've got to get. Is it still sticking in your teeth? Is it Mrs. Reynolds, still in my teeth? Can I just say, Miss Massey, you're so glad you went first now, aren't you? So glad. Mr. DeSalvo's adding up three numbers. It's taking him a while. Here we go. Better make sure we get this right, sir. Okay, so in that round, scoring 7 points, putting them currently in fourth place with a total of 21. We have Viking House. Scoring 8 points in that round. Oh, is that smell? Giving them a total of 23 in third place. It's Braveheart House. A total of 7. Putting them in second place with 25 points, it's Griffin House. So Phoenix, Miss Wingard, scoring 9 points. So Phoenix 26, Griffin 25, Braveheart 23, Viking 21. Effectively, Gary, you've got to neck the lot, mate. Okay, that's what it comes down to. So, Mr. El Canuni, Mr. DeSalvo, can you come forwards? Let's have a clue for our next country. So, okay, so guesses from the audience. Which country are we in, do we think? For Griffin House, we have Miss Markstein. For Phoenix, Threzzy. And for Viking House, getting a bit of team talk here from Mr. Freya, we've got Mr. Mulligan. Okay, so let's find out what you're going to be eating. Hang on. Oh, surely. A nice bit of roast lamb. So, just to let you know that this next round is awful. Okay? It's absolutely awful. In Morocco, they love nothing better than a bit of lamb's brains. Lamb's brains. Oh! I can almost smell them in the air now. Let's bring them out, but let's not uncover them. Let's not uncover them. So, do not uncover them. Do not uncover them. So, just to let you know that these lamb's brains have been prepared especially by Mr. Howzo for us. Now, they're normally eaten in Morocco, nice and hot with some spices, but you know what? Mr. Hounslow, he got my message wrong. He thought they needed to be ready for 9 o'clock this morning. So they've gone cold. In fact, we've had to chill them to make sure that they're still okay. So we have got some chilled lamb. Look at him. I've never seen it. It's food. I'm a PE teacher. I'll eat anything. Okay, so are we ready? We are going to have 1 minute on a countdown from 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's go! They are chilled. Mr. Henderson. Bit chewy, sir. she's loving it. Miss Markstein's going for it. She's going for it. Let's look, see what's happening. Mr. Threz. Mr. Threz is okay down here. He's enjoying. Oh! Mulligan's brought some back up. It's come back up. We've got 30 seconds to go. Let's come on. Who are you shouting for? Who are you trying to encourage today? Miss Markstein, he said, now we've got 15 seconds left. Don't stop now. It could make all the difference. It could make all the difference. So here we go. Let's stop it there. Oh, my goodness. So, you know, we've thrown some sweets into the audience. Do you not get fed very much at home or something? Is there anybody in the audience who would like to try a bit of lamb's brain? Here we go. Come on, Ashley, come up to the front. Okay, hang on a second. For those of you that are watching on YouTube, it's just a normal day at KBA. You've got a member of SLT dressed as a French chef feeding lamb's brains to Tinkerbell. It's just a normal day. So, Ashley, do you fancy a bit? Yum, yum. What do you think, Ashley? It's not that bad, is it? It's a delicacy. Delicacy. So, Mr. DeSalvo, are we ready with our final scores? Okay, so, if I let you know what we're going to do, I'm going to reveal the scores for this now. Then we're going to show you the big reveal for Term 1. It's going to have results from the House Cross Country, from our attendance competition, from our report competition. There's going to be over 1,400 house points on the totalizer. In fourth place for Trick or Treat, with a score of 5 points for Lamb's Brains, we have Viking House. In joint second place, scoring 7 points and 5 points respectively, we have Braveheart and Griffin House, which means that our winning house for Trick or Treat on 35 points, 9 points for Mr. Thres. Phoenix House are our winners. Let's give them all a round of applause. Ladies and gentlemen, are we ready at the back? Let's play the Term 1 big reveal.
He took the midnight train going anywhere. Just a city boy, born and raised in South Detroit. He took the midnight train going anywhere. A singer in a smoky room, a smell of wine and cheap perfume, for a smile they can share.